7-minute scientific rap session.
Along with my friend, his name is Ben. We've been working on species response to climate change, and we both agree that the magnitude of species response depends on the latitude. But we're not primed. Before 2018, other researchers like us, well, they already found the closer the equator, the harder the decline. With all the literature, we're one for louder rhyme. Because the same pattern exists on nesting success. The colder the place, the lower the thermal stress. But if you go down the latitude, the response reverses. At the hot part of the range, you better call them a nurse. And that's what I found with body size in France, more exactly on wing length at the juvenile stage. My results was better than expected by chance. Response depends on the location with the species range. I'm not the only one who found a contrasting trend with the differential response at both range ends. It also works at the between species scale ends. Talk about mountain, come on, tell them, Ben.
Yo, talk about mountains, they're practically perfect, biodiverse and beautiful, but now I'm feeling nervous. They're changing so fast, we can't curb it, and how species will respond is uncertain. We talk about climate change coming up next, but it's already here. We're living in the stress, like Pacific Northwest. It's supposed to be fresh, but it's 40 degrees and the smoke is a mess. So how have species already responded? Afraid it's not good news down in the tropics, where species that live up near the summit have seen their abundances and rain size plummet. It's the tropics where species are zooming up, and in the temperate zone they don't care as much. So escalated extinction runs faster in the tropics. And back to you, Nico, tell us more about this topic.
So we found evidence of latitude gradient in nature. Well, how wrong could it go in the future? Montel tropical species are the most in trouble, hey. So what do forecasting models say? I model the distribution of narrow-ranging species. The habitat is already cut into pieces. One of them lived in the mountains of Madagascar. Species will decline before this one, it's even faster. I choose this one because the data's real good. Tell algorithm,
well, climate model,
as far as I could. According to what 50k predictions show, the species will simply have nowhere to go. She lives this piss. Avec le changement climatique, c'est comme partout. Y'aura des gagnants et des perdants. Si tu veux le test, mieux vaut ne pas être asthmatique. Ou dans la course à traquer le climat, tu perdras tes dents. C'est ce qu'on essayait de te dire avec Ben Freeman. C'est que sous les climats tempérés, les espèces ne sont pas au top. Mais sous les tropiques, ça sera pire, c'est là que le danger émane. C'est là-bas qu'il faut concentrer les efforts pour éviter le flop. Regarde, c'est ce que j'ai trouvé pour ce gecko de la Réunion. Aujourd'hui on le trouve ici, demain je prédis l'extinction. Plus tu vis proche de l'équateur et moins t'as de marge. Un tout petit réchauffement suffit pour que tu n'emmènes pas large. Tout ceci marche aussi au sein d'une même espèce. Les populations les plus au sud subissent le plus de stress. Le changement climatique va toucher le plus grand nombre. Mais c'est là où le climat est chaud et humide, que l'avenir est sombre. Chaud, humide, sombre.